Okay guys, this is the follow-on video for the Mad-Eye Buffalo fish at Lone Star. I would normally be fishing from the other side of the lake for buffalo, smallmouth buffalo. So I would be fishing from over here, and I would normally fish from here and be fishing just beyond these lily pads, but it seems that the Mad-Eye Buffalo is reputedly around this area, so I'm actually fishing from the other side because it's easier to get the distance to get to about here somewhere, or maybe here. I've put a marker in that's in the deep water, but only just in the deep water, and I've obviously equipped the invisible line, which is the prerequisite that will get you the Mad-Eye as opposed to anything else. I've had to guess with everything else because I don't really know. I don't know how strong this line is, and I know dough balls and semolina balls work well for smallmouth, so let's give it a go anyway and see what happens. As I say, my marker is just on the edge of the deep water on the map. You can see on the map the deep water is darker. If you are not familiar with the way the map works, if you press the M key you'll see the map, and the darker sections are the deeper, and in this case the centre of the lake. I'm going to have to play around with the depth to try and see what works. I'd normally be fishing much higher up for the smallmouth, about 150, but at the moment I'm deeper than that. Let's just see what happens here. As I say, I've got my drag set to 1 because I really don't know what to expect in terms of power or size of this thing. The other problem is that you'll get you'll get panfish that will go for dough balls, so we could be fishing out all sorts of other crap before we get to this special fish. Just going to try tweaking it a bit. In terms of the time and the day, I've picked the first day where the peak coincides with the evening, and just fast forwarded until I got to that. So we'll see whether that works, because the little hint that comes up on the screen tells you that they prefer the middle of the lake and peak fishing times early morning and I think late evening. So if this doesn't work, we'll try another time. What I might try is just reeling in and changing the depth a bit. To be ready to jump on the plus and minus keys for drag when and if I do get it. I tried to fish for it from the other side of the lake where I would normally be, but had no luck, so giving this a try. Apologies once again for the poor quality of the video. But I'm not with my home main machine that's got the video recording on, so just doing this on an iPad at the moment. Float seems to be leaning quite a long way considering the supposed 1 meter per second wind speed. I don't think it's touching the bottom quite. I think it's tilting because of the wind. Missed that early morning or middle of the day, so I think we need to. I thought it said evening as well, so let's have a look. So we could forward on to 1400 or 1300. Good thing about Lone Star is it doesn't cost you anything to forward on, so. putting the depth right back down to 250 just to see whether that helps. Although I'm pretty sure even at the deepest part of this lake it's not that deep. Although that does look more promising. Go. Let's see. I'm just going to gently increase my drag till I don't think I can cope with any more. I really don't want to break this line. Although I suppose the worst that can happen is you put another two hook on and they bolt. Can we go one more or not? I don't think we can. No. Just going to have to be very, very patient with this. This is definitely the fish. There's no doubt about it. As you can see, the mission tracker is on the screen, so I haven't caught this yet, so I don't know really what to expect. Just going to try and coax this in. This is not an easy fish to land. Well, not with the tackle that I've chosen anyway. Of course, you're limited with the line. You've got to use the invisible line to be able to catch it, so. Just walking around the lake to the left, walking closer towards it, and we're getting there now, so yeah, this is going to be it. Probably a fairly ugly looking brute if I remember what last year's Halloween fish looked like. Battle scars. Okay guys, so that's it. It's 5.8 kilos. So I don't know what the strength of that line is, but it's pretty weak line. So so you need to be very careful landing it. And just to show you, Whistler, I was fishing from here out to about here, middle of the day, and you can do it on the, obviously using the invisible line, but go maximum depth, don't worry about whether the float's lying over or not. And good luck guys, and I'll see you next time.